Hello and welcome to all. In this video session, we will learn about SAP Purchase Order Cycle. This is our session number 3. In SAP Purchase Order Cycle, first stage is creation of purchase order. So we have raised a purchase order and we send that purchase order to our vendor. Second step is goods receipt. So with reference to the purchase order raised, vendor sends the invoice in our plant. Our plant persons, with reference to the purchase order, will check the quality and quantity of the product, and afterwards they will create a goods receipt in the transaction code MyGo. Goods receipt is a confirmation that whatever material mentioned in the purchase order has been received at our plant. So after goods receipt, we'll have to pay to our vendor. First, we have to create an invoice document. The transaction code to create an invoice document is MyRO. So we will learn about invoice document in this video session. So this can be the information in the invoices: address, purchase order, invoicing party, currency, tax rate, bank information, material quantity. Now we will do the practicals. So I will follow the menu path first. SAP menu, logistics, material management, logistic invoice verification, document entry, MyRO enter invoice. See, we have already created our purchase order. This is our purchase order number 45001-204, and we have already done the GR, that is goods receipt note, for this purchase order. So now, with reference to this purchase order, we will create or we will enter our invoice in the transaction MyRO. So first I will copy this purchase order. Double click on MyRO. Here I will give our company code. Now see, here I will paste that purchase order number, press enter, invoice date, I will put today's date. This MyRO transaction is a single screen transaction. We will discuss about some screen areas in this transaction code. So this is called as a transaction area. Okay, here we can define whether we want to enter an invoice by default invoice, or we can change this also to credit memo, subsequent debit, subsequent credit. So here we can select or we can define whether we want to enter an invoice or any of this options. Now see, this area is called as a header data. It includes, or this header data is divided into different tabs: basic data, payment details, tax, contacts, note. So here we can enter our respective data. Okay, yes, I will now enter a baseline date. So this area is called as a header area. Now this area, whether I have given our purchase order number, this area is called as a allocation area. This area is called as a allocation area. I enter our purchase order number. So purchase order is a document that an invoice refers to. So I have given a purchase order number. So this area is called as a allocation area. This area is called as a vendor data area. Here the system displays the vendor name, address, bank detail of the vendor. Okay, now this called as a balance area. It's called as a balance area. So in the balance area, system displays the current balance. Okay, and the traffic light icon shows us that whether the invoice can be posted or not. Code. So again, I will repeat just to remind. This area is called as a transaction area. This is a header area. This is a allocation area. This is vendor data area. This is a balance area. Now see, in balance area, amount is 675 UR. So this amount is we have to pay to our vendor. From where this amount came from? See, I will show you. To first, I will open a new session. I will create a new session and I will use a transaction code ME23N to display a purchase order. So this is our purchase order number. I will click on the expand header session. And now I will select conditions tab. See, net amount 675 EUR. So this is the amount we have to pay to the vendor, and this amount has reflected in our balance area of Myro transaction. Okay, now I will give the same amount in the column of amount in basic data. Now see, the traffic light was red and it is changed to green. Can be posted. Click on the simulate. Press enter. And now click on the post. Press enter. Document number has been created. Now we will check our purchase order history. To check a purchase order history, I will use a transaction code ME23N again. Okay, ME23N. Give your purchase order number. Now in purchase order history tab, we can see the purchase order history of this purchase order. So this is the goods receipt number and this is invoice receipt which we have just now created. If we click on this, system will open the document. So I will click on this invoice receipt document. Now see, this is the document, display invoice document. Just like that, if you click on the goods receipt or material document, system will open the material document, that is goods receipt document. So this is a display material document. We'll take back and this document will be sent to the vendor. So this is how we can create an invoice in our system. So that's all for now in this video.